I've been roaming about the poster halls trying to find those band of hugely enthusiastic early career academics about which I am so complimentary and which are so important to the ESD in the future. And I found these three. So tell me who you are.
My name is Tatenda Chimanda, and I'm from Maastricht University.
I'm Kim Massen, and I'm from Maastricht University as well.
Matthias van den Ende, and also from Maastricht University.
So a full sweep for Maastricht University there. So tell me about your posters. Who wants to go first?
Matthias, you can go. You can start.
So my poster is about the effect of a weight loss intervention in obese individuals to reduce reactive dicarbonyl stress present in obese individuals, and for example as well in type 2 diabetics.
And did it work?
It did actually. Reactive dicarbonyls were significantly reduced after an 8-week weight loss intervention.
And what kind of weight loss intervention was it?
This was a caloric restriction intervention. High caloric restriction, a normal caloric restriction, and then a 2 weeks weight stable phase afterwards. So 8 weeks in total.
Okay, very good. And how about you? What was your... You did an oral presentation, which must have been very nerve-wracking.
Yes, it was exciting. I just got back from, so still high in adrenaline. But it was... We looked in humans to... their habitual diet and the amount and the quality of carbohydrates that they consumed over the year. And then we looked at the effect of postprandial glucose peaks and how from postprandial glucose it could be converted and damage sugar-modified proteins, which we're investigating and is known to cause the complications of diabetes.
And what did you find?
We found that mainly the quantity of carbohydrates that people consume in their daily diet is a contributor of the amount of advanced glycation end products, these sugar-modified proteins that we could find back in their body.
Terrific. And how about you? Because yours was basic science, wasn't it?
Mine is a little bit more investigative and using animal models. Less animal models and more cultured cells. So we basically found out that in insulin-resistant people, there's an increase of these so-called dicarbonyls. And we sort of envisioned that these dicarbonyls might play a role in the progress of insulin resistance from the beginning to the sort of the incidence of insulin resistance. And through this, we tried to see how concentrations of of the dicarbonyls can sort of interact and affect insulin signaling. That's a lot of big words.
A lot of big words.
Yeah.
But you're very good at them.
Okay, thank you.
Right. So I'm going to just ask you all now, have you enjoyed EASD and what's next for you all?
Yeah, it's been quite a really fun environment. It's my first time here and I was really, really surprised by the size of it. There's quite a lot of people. And what's coming next will be, there's another sort of more smaller conference in the Netherlands that's held for young researchers. So hopefully we'll go polish our presenting skills there.
And when's that?
This will be next week.
Oh, next week?
Yeah, next week. Yeah, we're on the road.
Okay, so we just, you know, we're polishing you up and shoving you out the door.
Yeah.
Okay, how about you? How have you found EASD? What do you get out of it?
It's incredible. I'm impressed with the amount, because I have a nutrition background and it's not so much in our department, but I really like... cricked up my skills on nutrition and diabetes, so that's been really good about this conference, and especially like the size and the variety of talks that's out there and the amount of choice has just been overwhelming.
And what's been the best one you've gone to?
That's a tough one because there have been several really good ones. There was one this morning on nutrition of the mother during pregnancy and DNA methylation that will eventually affect the health outcomes of the newborn. So how pregnancy actually affects the child of the health of the child before birth even. So that was really impressive. So I think that one stopped ranking.
And how about you?
I thought it was magnificent. The overall size and the quality of the speakers and on all the posters as well was really was magnificent. So very interesting. Yeah.
And what was your best pick so far?
Well, I really liked the Golgi lecture of Peter Navrat. That was very interesting and overall also very relevant, I guess, for our topic regarding glycemic control and dicarbonyl stress and advanced glycation end products. It was also regarding this was very interesting. Yeah.
And you're organizing your own meeting, I hear.
Yes, we are. This year we attended a young age meeting Which is held annually, and it's for young researchers in the field of the Maillard reaction, so the reaction that we're actually all investigating. And we have the honor to host it next coming April 2019. So if there are any young researchers out there that are interested in working in the field of the Maillard reaction, either master's or PhD levels, then we'd very much like to welcome everyone in Maastricht.
So for the topic of the what's the word I'm looking for now?
Symposia.
For the topic of the symposia, it's not necessarily that you have to be clinical. We can also have food chemistry, so it's quite broad in...
So very inclusive.
Very, very inclusive. And we sort of try to share research ideas and just to see where the general sort of scope of the topic has been going. And it will be held in Maastricht University, in Maastricht.
Excellent. Maastricht, a very fine place to go. Maastricht, of course, a word that we Brits, with Brexit, it was the beginning of the end, Maastricht. So we maybe won't be in Europe by the time you get to this meeting, but we're very much crossing our fingers. You can see all the presentations of these good folk on EASD.org.